Okay, so here's the question. From your nanny to your dog walker to your hairdresser, it's the holidays. What do you tip? When? Who? Why? How much? Oh, there's so many questions. Bruce Sellery here to answer
everything. You have to remember that tipping is not an obligation.
Okay.
It is to honor someone's service. And the amount that you tip really depends on context and your personal circumstances.
Okay.
So the context is, if you're getting your hair done at a fancy salon in Yorkville, that's a different game than if you're going to your local barber in the Junction and you go there every 3 weeks. The other thing on personal circumstances is, do you have the money to afford it? Because I don't want people, you know, slapping down $200 onto a credit card just so they can make a tip.
Well, things are already tight this time of year,
they're
right?
They're tight. They're really, really tight. And a lot of people think, oh, I didn't put tipping on my budget, my holiday budget. I had a gift for my mother-in-law, but I didn't think about tipping. Now, I want to give you an enormous caveat to my advice on it's not an obligation. Sometimes it is an obligation.
Okay, and in those scenarios, we're talking about people who would be an obligation, would you say?
A nanny.
A nanny's an obligation.
A nanny. And here's why it's an obligation. And I say that, you know, with a take me with a bit of a grain of salt, is caregivers talk to each other.
Sure.
And so a tip will not get you past being a crummy employer 12 months a year, right?
Right?
Like, you can't be like, oh, here's a Here's $100.
That would make you a crummy employer just for yelling
just
like that.
You're just a crummy employer. So, but at the same time, that is someone who, you know, you and I are both parents.
Yeah.
It's a different category. So there are places where you sort of feel like that's discretionary, but that one is critical. So should we go through some numbers?
Let's go through numbers because everyone's saying, okay, what do we do? So let's start with someone who cleans your home.
Yeah, so you would say the benchmark is a half to one full service. So if you pay $100 to your cleaning fees, $100, $50 would be the gratuity. Hairdresser, I love that I'm a guy putting this in here, but I don't know what women spend. Does women spend more than $20 getting their hair done?
Yes.
A little bit more than that?
Correct.
Yeah. So say you spend $100 on a cut, we'll forget the color, maybe it's $50. Trainer, this one I think is optional. That being said, the trainers, your viewers out there who are trainers are like, no, bring
more,
it on,
more.
Of course. And then teacher, this is a real range within the community in which you live. So if you're in a lower income neighborhood, it may be that you don't get anything for the teacher. You do a nice card. If you're in a super high income neighborhood, a lot of times people will pool that. I'm the guy in my school.
You're in charge
to organize
of
the parents. Yeah. And so we people give the money to me and I take 20% off the top. Of course.
Okay.
Kidding. Kidding.
No,
totally
he's not.
Kidding.
No, he's not. This is how he makes his money. This is financial planning.
We get gift cards. We give gift cards to the teacher.
And yay or nay, a bottle of wine to a teacher.
I think that can be a no-no because you don't have, if you know them really, really well and you know that they're a white or a red or they like Merlot or whatever, maybe it's just safer to give them an LCBO gift card.
Okay.
And then you can sort of imply that they're using that card to take wine to a friend's house versus boozing quietly while they binge watch The Crown, right? So you have to be a little cautious about that. Booze for the teacher. Another not to do is going overboard. This is the thing. If you already have credit card debt that you are not going to be able to eliminate by March, then you can't be a big tipper because what you're then doing is just trying to do that for your own ego when you simply can't afford it. Don't tip your dentist. So salary employees, well, sometimes people are like, I don't know, do I tip everybody?
And then they just start going,
I just tip everybody.
Crazy.
So don't do that. Don't tip your dentist.
You mentioned one thing about the nanny is like, kind of like an obligation-ish. Now, here's one that might scare some people.
Yeah.
What would be a nanny's tip?
1 week.
Salary.
So, yeah, 1 week salary. And, you know, depending on where you live, the nanny community makes different amounts of money. So let's say it's $500 to $1,000 a week. I don't know, you know, where that is on the range. That would be what you would tip. Technically, you need to declare it. Technically, you need to declare it. So
that's
I'm just putting that out there. People are going to do what they're going to do. And I think the important thing is, if it's not an obligation, it's to honor one's service. Write a lovely card, like an amazing, amazing card for these people, because that does count. Doesn't count. It's not worth $500 necessarily.
But it's something.
It's something.
From the heart.
From the heart.
That's all that matters.
Yeah.
Okay, all the information. We're going to post all this. BreakfastTelevision.ca, and people can ask you questions on your Twitter handle, which
absolutely.
Is...
Absolutely. At Bruce Sellery with an S.
At Bruce Sellery with an S.
And you don't have to tip me. I'm good.
Are you
really?
Sure?
I don't even need a card. I just need, like, the warmth of your presence and a smile.
Well, here it is.
Oh, and a
hug.
Yeah.
I'm gonna bring in a Kevin too. A Kevin too. He gets one of those too?